Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. In this video I'll show you how to install Linux Mint 21 Dual Boot with macOS on a 2012 MacBook Pro. First open your favorite browser. Then go to google.com. In the Google search box type Linux Mint. Then click the linuxmint.com link. Scroll down this page and you will find Linux Mint features. Linux Mint is an operating system for desktop and laptop computers. It is designed to work out of the box and comes fully equipped with the apps most people need. Linux Mint already provides various applications such as for graphic design, productivity, web, multimedia and gaming. For more detailed features you can read on this page. To download Linux Mint 21 ISO click download. Linux Mint has three editions. First, the Cinnamon edition. Cinnamon is a desktop environment for the X Windows system that derives from GNOME 3. The second is Mate edition. Mate is a classic desktop environment that is a continuation of GNOME 2, Linux Mint's default desktop between 2006 and 2011. And the third is the XFCE edition. XFCE is a lightweight desktop environment. It doesn't support as many features as Cinnamon or Mate. Because Cinnamon edition was mainly developed for and by Linux Mint, so I downloaded Cinnamon edition. To download Cinnamon Edition ISO click on Torrent Download 64-bit. Now double click on the torrent file to start the Linux Mint ISO download. Then select folder to save the downloaded Linux Mint ISO. Then click the OK button. The download process will start immediately and wait for the download process to complete. The Linux Mint ISO download process is complete. Then close the Torrent client application. Now reopen your favorite browser. Then open a new tab. Then go to google.com. In the Google search box type Belina Etcher. Click on Belina Etcher's link. To download Belina Etcher click the Download for macOS menu. Wait for Belina Etcher's download process to complete. The download process has been completed, then click the Show in Finder icon. Now drag the Belina Etcher file to the desktop. Double-click the Belina Etcher to mount to the desktop. In the window that show up, drag Belina Etcher to Applications. Now close Belina Etcher mount window. Also eject Belina Etcher mount window on desktop. You can run Belina Etcher via Launchpad. Now insert USB flash drive into MacBook USB port. And on the desktop a USB flash drive mount point will appear. Now open Disk Utility. In the Disk Utility window click View and then click Show All Devices. In the left window of Disk Utility, click USB flash drive. And in the right window of Disk Utility, click the erase button. And for the name of the USB flash drive, I choose untitled. On format, select MS-DOS FAT. On scheme, select master boot record. Then click erase. After the erase process is complete, then click the done button. Then close the Disk Utility window. Now open Balina Etcher. In the window that show up, click the open button. In the Balina Etcher window, click on flash from file. Select the Linux Mint ISO, then click the open button. Now click select target. Click on the USB flash drive and then click on the select button. Click flash to start the Linux Mint bootable USB creation. In this window, enter your Mac admin password. And then click the OK button. The process of flashing Linux Mint ISO to USB flash drive is in progress, and wait for the process to finish. The Linux Mint ISO flashing process is complete, then close Balina Etcher. Now open Disk Utility again. In the left window of Disk Utility, click on Container Disk 1. In the right window of Disk Utility, click Partition. Then click Partition again. In Partition window, click plus icon. Then click the Apply button. Then click Partition. Then click on Continue. Wait for the SSD partitioning process to finish. The SSD partitioning process is complete. Then click Done. Then close the Disk Utility window. Now restart MacBook. Once the MacBook Pro screen turns gray, press the Option key until the boot menu options show up. On the boot menu, select EFI Boot USB Flash Drive. On the Grub menu, select it, then press Enter on Start Linux Mint 21 Cinnamon 64-bit. Now click on Linux Mint Start menu. Go to Administration and then select Guarded. In the Guarded window, select Partition for Linux Mint. Then right click on the partition. Now select Format to, then select EXT4. Now click on the Apply icon. Then click Apply again. The partition format process for Linux Mint is complete, then click Close. Now close the guarded window. Now click on Install Linux Mint icon on desktop. Here you can choose your language. Then click on Continue. Here you can choose your keyboard layout. Then click on Continue. Here click the checkbox on Install Multimedia Codecs. Multimedia codecs are required to play some video formats and to render some websites correctly. Then click on Continue. Here under Installation type, select on Something Else. In this option we can create or resize partitions or select multiple partitions for Linux Mint. Then click on Continue. Now scroll down until you find a partition of type ext4. Then click on the partition and then a partition edit window will appear. On Use as select from the drop-down menu as ext4. Don't forget to select format the partition. In mount point select from drop-down menu as root. Then click OK button. You will now be warned once again that changes will occur to the disk. As long as everything is OK, click the Continue button. Now click on the root partition again and then click on the Install Now button. Here you can choose your location. Then click on Continue. Here you can set up user, computer name, username, and also password for username. If you want to log in automatically without entering password, then select Login Automatically. Then click on Continue. Now the installation process has started. This can take anywhere from 10 minutes to an hour. Just wait until the installation process is complete. The installation process is complete. Now click on Restart Now button. Congratulations, once you log in you will be greeted by the welcome window. Just close this welcome window. Now check the Wi-Fi adapter. As you can see, the Wi-Fi adapter is not detected yet. So we need to install Wi-Fi driver first. Because I will install the Wi-Fi driver through the repository, so I need a LAN cable to connect the MacBook to the internet. Connect the LAN cable to the MacBook Pro's Ethernet port. Now the MacBook is connected to the internet. Now open terminal. In terminal type sudo apt install firmware b43 installer. Press enter and then enter your password. Then press enter again. Type Y then press enter to continue the installation. Wait until the Wi-Fi driver installation process is complete. The Wi-Fi driver installation process is complete. Then close the terminal window. Now restart the MacBook for the drivers to take effect immediately. Now the MacBook has finished restarting. Now we need to check Wi-Fi driver working or not. As you can see, the Wi-Fi driver is working normally. Now we try to connect to a Wi-Fi hotspot. As you can see, now it has successfully connected to the Wi-Fi hotspot. That was how to install Linux Mint 21 Dual Boot with macOS on MacBook Pro 2012. And if you have any questions, just comment down below. See you in the next video.